Hello friends, in the last video, we had seen two data distributions for continuous variables, that is exponential distribution and weibull distribution. Now it's time to learn third data distribution for continuous data. In this video, I am going to explain normal distribution with practical example. So let's begin. 3. Normal distribution. The normal distribution is the most common statistical distribution because approximate normality arises naturally in many physical, biological and social measurement situations. Many statistical analysis requires that the data came from normally distributed populations. The normal distribution, also known as Gaussian distribution. It is often called as a bell curve because the graph of its probability density resembles bell shape. 7 features of normal distribution and normality test in Minitab. As you know, I had mentioned this is in very detail while explanation of histogram. If you want to refresh it, you can learn it by clicking on this card. Measures of central tendency and dispersion. The normal distribution is a continuous probability distribution described by two parameters. These parameters are population mean mu and population standard deviation sigma. Probability distribution function for normal distribution is given by this formula. Here, mu is the mean and sigma is the standard deviation. Cumulative distribution function for normal distribution is given by this formula. This integral cannot be easily solved. However, we can use tables of standard normal distribution which are readily available. Standard normal distribution has mean is equal to 0 and standard deviation is equal to 1. Any other normal distribution can be transformed to the standard normal distribution to calculate areas between or beyond x values. Z value converts the x value into a standard value. Z is calculated by x minus mu divided by sigma. Here, z value is the distance of x from the mean mu in number of standard deviations. Now, let's see some examples to understand it in more detail. Example 1. A component exhibits normal distribution for failure rate. Mean is equal to 3500 hours. With standard deviation of 500 hours, what percentage of parts will be survived up to 4500 hours? Here, mu is equal to 3500, sigma is equal to 500, and x is equal to 4500. Then, z is equal to 4500 minus 3500 whole divided by 500, which is equal to 2. For z is equal to 2, shaded area is 0.9772. Thus, probability of parts will be failed is 97.72% and reliability is equal to 1 minus 0.9772, which is equal to 0.0228. That is, 97.72% of parts will be failed up to 4500 hours and 2.28% population will survive. We can also use Excel to find out probabilities related to normal distribution random variables. Probability is equal to normdist x, comma mean, comma standard deviation, comma cumulative. That is, probability for less than 4500 hours is equal to normdist 4500, comma 3500, comma 500, comma true, which is equal to 0.9772. And reliability is equal to 1 minus 0.9772, which is equal to 0.0228. That is, 97.72% of parts will be failed up to 4500 hours and 2.28% population will survive. Example 2. A company has realized that they can develop a new part with a mean of 24 days and a standard deviation of 8 days. Assuming normal distribution, what duration they should commit to a customer at 95% of confidence interval? Here, mu is equal to 24, sigma is equal to 8 and standard normal probability is equal to 0.95. Let's consider a commitment of x days to the customer. From the table of standard normal probabilities, z value corresponding to probability of 0.95 is 1.65. Now, z is equal to x minus mu upon sigma. Therefore, x minus mu is equal to z into sigma. That is, x minus 24 is equal to 1.65 into 8, which is equal to 37.2. That is, they should commit development time of 37 days to the customer. This is all about normal distribution. we will start learning of measurement system analysis from the next video. For references, I have taken some part of this content from Minitab and Institute of Quality and Reliability. Now to end, please like this video if you have found it useful. Share this video to your friends and colleagues to improve and refresh their knowledge. If you want to get updates of such videos from my channel, please do not forget to subscribe it and click on the bell icon to get all notifications. And finally, thank you for watching.